I was told once that I am unconnable. I don't believe that. I believe that statement in itself was somebody trying to con me. I don't think I'm unconnable. I don't think anybody is. I may be difficult to con, but I'm not unconnable. Meaning I can be deceived, even though it may be hard. Why did the guy say that? I saw him running this hustle with the cup thing, where, you know, the people try to guess the cup. I just asked him one day, I said, how is it that you were able to fool so many people with this stuff and any other type of cons? He said, oh, well, you never come by my table. I can tell you why. I said, why? He said, well, you know, you're not countable because you don't think you can get something for nothing. Do you think you can get something for nothing? I said, no, I don't think I can get something for nothing. Everything requires some type of work or exchange. He stopped and said, see, there you go. That's why it's going to be hard to con you, but I can get other people. And that stuck with me because I hear about people abusing their positions of authority and influence over some of their subordinates. And you hear about people just taking advantage of whatever fame or popularity or position they have over other people. And one thing they do to lure their victims in, especially when you're talking about people trying to make it an entertainment, is they promise, from what I've been reading and hearing, they get people because they try to promise them not necessarily something for nothing, but something for very little effort. Or like, I'm going to make it easier for you to do X, Y, Z. I'm going to make it because you're special. And I'm going to make an easy road for you. So that's how these predators are able to easily abuse their prey. Especially if you're talking about a young person, because a younger person does not have enough life experience yet to know that there's no magic in the world. This person is not going to magically grant you or give you the keys to paradise for nothing. They're going to want something in return, even if it's just your own hard work and dedication. Okay? If they're giving it to you and they're giving you a shortcut, you're either going to have to stroke their ego, you know, or kiss up to them, or they're going to have to be able to basically take advantage of you, if not outright abuse you, for you to get this thing that you want so bad. And then because you want it so bad, you keep coming back. And they take advantage of your want and your desire to get you to do things or to ignore things that deep down inside you don't like or you think are wrong or you don't feel comfortable. So that's how they get you. They get people because, and I know how it is, as I've worked towards several goals. You know, you start working towards a goal and then you're just not meeting the goal. You're just not making it. It's not happening. You've been plugging away and plugging away at a time and it just seems like it's not paying off. So it's two things you can do. You can give up. You can keep going. But then this person comes and offers a third way, and that is you don't have to give up. But you don't have to keep going, expending the amount of effort that you have been doing. I can give you this shorter, easier road, the shortcut. Come to me. I'll do it for you. And it sounds good. But you might feel a little bit of a knot in your stomach or something like that. Because you go, I don't know. But, you know. They give you their little shortcut, or they pretend that they're going to give you a shortcut or something. They make all these promises to you about how they're going to help you become famous, become rich, obtain a title, you know, just reach whatever milestone it is that you want, that you've been trying to get for so long, that you've been dreaming about ever since you can remember. And here it is. They're going to give it to you. Every other door seems like it's closed, but they're going to open a door for you. And they get you. And by the time you realize that they've been lying to you and just been using you and taking advantage of you, then you feel ashamed. You feel bad. You feel unworthy. You might even feel stupid. Because you feel like, man, I can't believe I let this person take advantage of me. Not to mention the trauma of whatever wrong thing or abuse. Or, you know, if it's like one of these financial cons, the trauma is to your bank account. But let me tell you, despite the fact that, you know, what they did is what some people call using the greed of the mark. I'm sure that terminology is outdated now, but that's what I remember being called. Using the greed of the mark. That means they're using your own greed, your own desire, your own want or wants to hook you in like bait. That's basically what it is. The fisherman puts the worm on the end of the hook. Because if you just stuck the hook in the water, the fish wouldn't bite it. But once you have that worm on the end of that hook, the fish are so fixated on the worm, they don't see the hook. Then they go after the worm and bam, they're caught. It's caught in their mouth. And the more they try to pull away, the more they bleed. And they're caught. And they're taken out of water. So despite them taking advantage of your greed, I'm here to tell you, it's still not your fault. Because they are wrong. You're not supposed to take advantage of people. You're especially not supposed to take advantage of children when you are an adult, or even if you are a child. You're not supposed to take advantage of people. You're not supposed to take advantage of women. You're not supposed to take advantage of children. You're not supposed to take advantage of men. So when these folks are using your own lower desires or your own desperation, your own desire to make it, or whatever, or you have some type of compulsion towards some type of self-destruction behavior, some type of addiction. I know we live in a world of take responsibility. And you might be able to take advantage to a point. Take responsibility to a point. But just remember, they are taking advantage of you, and they are wrong. And that is why, I don't care how much people want to sit back and blame victims, that is why there are laws against what predators do. So the only thing I can tell you from a martial arts perspective is to try to work those tenets of self-control and indomitable spirit from Taekwondo. It's hard, man. Everybody's been taken advantage of and deceived at some point in life. But the best you can do is try to learn from your mistakes so that you don't keep giving your time, money, and energy and effort over to the deceivers. Once you find out somebody's deceiving anyone, even if it's not just you, you gotta part ways with them, cut ties. Because the next thing you know, you're next. Peace.